Hello everyone, my name is Ever Barbero, and today I'd like to talk about example 8.3 in my textbook, Finite Element Analysis of Composite Materials Using Abacus. In this example, you will learn how to use a U-mat, that simulates damage in a unidirectional composite, using Rosen's damage model, and how to calculate the stress-strain response, and the tensile strength of the composite. First, we set the work directory, to hold all the files for this example. Now open example 2.4 and saved it as example 8.3. Example 2.4 has the model of a simple rod under tensile load. Now we use the dimensions tool, to modify the length of the bar. Now we need to regenerate the part. Now we need to regenerate the assembly. Now delete the material from example 2.4, and create a new one. A user material needs two things, properties, and the number of dependent variables. Here we have four properties: the elastic modulus of the fiber, the Weibull shape parameter of the fiber, and the product alpha times delta. See the textbook for details. We need two dependent variables, to hold the effective stress, gamma hat, and the damage variable, d. Now we edit the section, to change its cross-section area. Now delete the load from example 2.4, and replace it by an applied displacement. Now apply a displacement where the load was. Now we mesh, seating so that we get 5 elements, and 6 nodes. But I don't see the nodes. Use menu, view, assembly display options, mesh, show node labels. Now create a set to track the history of element results, on element 5. Now edit the step, to get a simulation time equals 50, and increment equals 1, for a nicer plot. Since we are using a U-mat, edit the field output request, to include the solution dependent variables, SDV. Also edit the history output request, to get the history of stress, strain, and SDV for set 5, which points to element 5. In module job, point to the user subroutine, UMAT, that you can download from my website. And here is the UMAT. Here are the state variables. And scrolling down to the bottom, we can see the state variables, or SDVs. SDV1 contains the effective stress, and SDV2 the damage variable D. In tab parallelization, set multiple processors to the number of virtual processor your machine has, which usually is double the number of cores. Now results. In results, go to step 30. SDV1 equals 3045 is the effective stress in the fiber, almost the fiber tensile strength of 3060 MPa, so the specimen is about to break. Now we save and plot the history results. So the peak stress is at frame 33 or 34, with a value slightly above 3000. Now we operate on XY data, to plot stress versus strain. Okay, that's it for today. If you liked this video, don't forget to subscribe. You can find more details in the textbook by following the link in the description. Thank you.